bus. The kid asks for change from strangers at the train station. He arranges his face to the poor, sad kid position with precision, acting skills drilled to perfection. Daily, he waits by the train, giggles with his mates at the game he is playing, laughs at the suckers with no sense who just gave him 50 cents, smokes cigarettes, looks about 10. I was one of them, not a begging kid. I was one of the people who did stop at the top of the steps to be met with his poor, sad kid eyes, and I fell for his line of lies about how he lost his money for the bus ride. Now, I wasn't born yesterday. I guessed it could be a prank, but coming from the country where people are honest, my immediate reaction was to give him $2 and the benefit of the doubt. Help the kid out. Then I watched him go and put my money in his kitty. And I felt a funny sense of pity that this small kid in this big city could be so indecently affected, so morally neglected that he finds this a cool after-school activity. The fools he pulls in trust him implicitly because children's faces are one of the few things in this base and vulgar place that we usually don't view with a sense of hate. But this case just proves that any trace of innocence we had left to lose is already gone. Hopped on the train with a maimed ideology, bled down the drain of mainstream apathy. If the eyes of a child reflect his society, that I know... Although the eyes of a child reflect his society, and although I know his actions are his responsibility, I can't help thinking he's been failed by his community. If it takes a village to raise a child, then what do you do when the village has gone wild? Whether the hand that rocks the cradle rules the world or not, the cradle still needs to be rocked, not knocked off or forgotten. And I have to say that I felt rotten sitting there watching this little guy, already believing that deceiving is the way of receiving what you're wanting or needing. And I think of the money I gave him and how it's not going to save him. Two honest dollars I earned about to be dishonestly burned in the dying cigarette of a boy whose lost and lying eyes I will never forget. The kid asks for change from strangers at the train station. He's begging for change. He's begging for change. Yeah.